Let's find the point on the circle x squared plus y squared equals 4 that is closest and slash furthest from 3, 1. Now, we should reformulate the question because it does not sound like the type of question that fits the format here. So closest furthest means we're doing min and max of distance. So a point on the circle, let's see, the distance between a point on, just, you know, just take a generic point on the circle, x, y, and the distance between that point on the circle and the point 3, 1, it's given by this formula, right? The distance formula. But here's the thing, instead of minimizing or maximizing d itself, it's actually much easier to minimize the square, right? So the thing is, if you have a bunch of numbers in order and you were to square root, the numbers would stay in order. If you were to square, the numbers would stay in order. Square root, the point is, does not change the order in which the numbers occur because square root is an increasing function. So let's, instead of minimizing or maximizing d, let's minimize or maximize the square of d, which is f of x, y equals x minus 3 quantity squared plus y minus 1 quantity squared. What about the constraint? The constraint is the point has to be on the circle, right? So we've got x squared plus y squared equals 4, or rather g of x, y equals 4, where by g of x, y, we mean x squared plus y squared. Okay, so we have turned the question into the right format. With our f of x, y and g of x, y, so min max f of x, y subject to g of x, y equals 4. So we'll compute gradient of f, gradient of g. I computed the gradient of f using chain rule instead of distributing out the squares first. Let's see. So we'll set gradient of f equal to lambda times gradient of g. And so we're going to have a setup that looks like this. First components, 2x minus 6 equals lambda times 2x. We'll call that equation A. 2y minus 2 equals lambda times 2y. We'll call that equation B. We had this original constraint, which we'll call equation C. And from A, just dividing by 2 on both sides, we have x minus 3 equals lambda x. If we get the terms with x on one side, so we'd have x minus lambda x, then equals 3, and you can factor out an x. Now, this looks like funky algebra, but it's going to work out. The whole point is this is going to show that lambda can't be 1. Why can't lambda be 1? If lambda were 1, then we would have x times 0 equals 3, which is impossible. So lambda cannot be 1. From equation B, we divide both sides by 2 and get y minus 1 equals lambda times y. And so we have here, you know, by rearranging in the same way, y times the quantity 1 minus lambda is equal to 1. We actually rediscover the fact that lambda can't be 1. But here's the thing, since lambda can't be 1, we have that, so if lambda can't be 1, then 1 minus lambda can't be 0, right? So we can divide by 1 minus lambda on both sides now, right? It's actually really important to be careful when dividing on both sides to make sure we don't accidentally divide by 0, and just if there's a variable floating around, you might accidentally divide by 0. So we do need to be really careful with some of the algebra. So let's take x times quantity 1 minus lambda equals 3. And now that we know 1 minus lambda is not 0, let's divide by that on both sides and get x equals 3 over 1 minus lambda. We'll call that equation D. In the same way, we're going to take an earlier equation, y times 1 minus lambda equals 1. Now that we know what's in parentheses is not 0, divide by that on both sides. We have y is equal to 1 over 1 minus lambda, which we call equation E. Go to the top of the next slide. Let's take those two equations that we just saw, x equals a fraction, y equals a fraction. Substitute those into equation C, which was the circle equation. We get a thing that looks like this. I know this looks a little messy. 3 over 1 minus lambda quantity squared plus 1 over 1 minus lambda quantity squared equals 4. But what's nice is that this is all in one variable, right? So we'll do a little algebra, apply the square to the top and bottom of each fraction separately. I guess by doing some rearranging, common denominator, right? So 10 over 1 minus lambda quantity squared. Yeah, 10 over the square of 1 minus lambda is equal to 4. So multiplying both sides by 1 minus lambda squared, so that ends up on the right side, divide both sides by 4, so 10 over 4, in other words, 5 over 2. Let's see, we can now square root both sides, which introduces a plus or minus sign, do a little bit of rearranging work. You are going to get lambda is equal to 1 plus or minus root 5 halves. Then let's look at, again, this plus or minus sign, it is the word or, so we actually get two values of lambda, which we should examine separately. And if we look at lambda is equal to 1 plus root 5 halves, then using DNE, we'll get this combo of x and y values. And if we use lambda is equal to 1 minus root 5 halves, then we get the following combo of values. So let's evaluate f at both of these xy's. So we get the z value to be 10 times quantity root 2/5 plus 1 squared. And so that's, remember that the f value is the square of the distance, so we should square root that number to get the distance. And then here we can do the same with the other combo of xy values that we got. And so we get the f value to be 10 times the quantity root 2/5 minus 1 close parentheses squared. So then that number square rooted is the distance. So in other words, root 10 times the quantity root 2/5 minus 1. Okay, so these are the only two distances that we have. Here we should conclude from the point 3, 1, if we're only examining points on the circle, x squared plus y squared equals 4, then the furthest point is, this one, because, negative 3 root 2/5, comma, negative root 2/5, that's the furthest point. Because that's the bigger value of distance here with the plus sign. With the minus sign, this is going to be a smaller number. Okay, so that's the closest point. So we get the furthest and closest point. Let's take a look at a picture of this, shall we? Okay, here we are. So we only want to consider points that are on the circle. And here's the point 3, 1, which is not on the circle. And which point is the furthest and which point is the closest? Well, the closest is right here. How do we do this? Yeah, there we go. The closest is this point. And then the furthest we had computed was that point.